process of building my studio basically here. I keep experimenting with different plans and processes, and you know, no process means anything unless there's an action step with it. So one of the things I put in the description just now was our finish line. Oh, we're going to have success. Yay. It pays to persist. Here's a good lesson in persistence right here. Fighting to get onto Facebook. You didn't actually want to do it at first, but now it's finally doing it. So what is persistence? You know, persistence is not just the first enthusiasm that people have at the very, very beginning of something they get involved with. That's not necessarily persistence. Persistence is when things are not perfect or when things go completely bad and yet you still stay with it. For instance, I have phones and I have all of my other screens here, and my actual plan with this setup is that once I know that that works, then the next thing I will do is actually have multiple screens going. That means four screens going. And that will allow me to actually go live in several other places. So that ought to be a lot of fun to figure out. But I am all about persistence. You know, it's not about staying with a company necessarily. It's about staying with your plan, your dream, your plan, everything that you want in life. And if it changes, if things have to be adjusted, if you have to make a whole new plan and start over, that is what persistence is. That you don't just give up the whole thing and quit and give up, which I see a lot of people doing, unfortunately. It can mean, as you know, even when something goes wrong and you lose it all and you still decide to pull back up and go for it again. I can tell you I've done that many, many times. And I know for a fact that you can too. Now, what persistence isn't is being insanely attached to a particular set of behaviors that are not proven to work. I talked a little bit about this in another video, which did not end up going live because the live wasn't working, but I did go ahead and put it in my blog, and it'll probably be in there sometime next week. And that is, you cannot go to a point where you decide to do something and go to a point of insanity and don't realize that real success comes from being willing to not only persist, but being willing to change and adjust as you go along, because very likely there's going to be times when things are not going to work the way you think they're going to work. And you might find that you have to make totally different changes, and you have to be okay with doing that. And that takes a lot of effort and a lot of work, and it sometimes isn't as easy to figure that part out, because what you really want is just to just go and do it in some kind of mindless fashion. But that's not real success. That can truly turn into something that is not going to work. For instance, I'll just give you an example. I see a lot of the time people actually doing the same kinds of posts, the same kinds of spamming all day long every day, thinking that that is actually persistence. That's not persistence. That's insanity. Because insanity, if you know what the common description of insanity is, continuing to do the very same thing over and over and over without any adjustment, without any change, expecting something to get better and something good to happen from it. And that is not what I mean by persistence. What I mean by persistence is as you go along, you have to be willing to continually adjust and change plans. I, over this whole year, have gone through about 15 or 20 different changes in plans, mainly, especially because my husband had to have a big change made in his life so that he could be in a more comfortable situation. He's now downstairs, and the bedroom is now downstairs. This room was our original bedroom, and I'm still working on making it work for me. It's, although it's larger, it doesn't work as much with storage because I don't have all of the great closet space I had in the other room. So I am still working on little adjustments and changes almost on a daily basis to make this more comfortable and more workable. But there are certain things I know are important, for instance, this video, and I know I need to do that. So I will stay with that and stay on it until it's done. And I did do that. As you can see at the beginning of the video, I had to go back and restart this before it actually attached into Facebook. And when I get done, another thing I always do is I share it all over Facebook. And I also do an email, and I make sure that it goes out to my list. So that's a daily activity that I do that helps me market and show people what I do and how I help them. And I have to make that a routine. Now, does that mean everything is absolutely the same all the time? No, because just like I found a new place for my camera and I had to change and reattach my USB hubs because that appeared to be the reason why this video was not working before. And I also had some drives that decided that they weren't going to work, and I went and bought a new one yesterday and ended up copying a lot of files off onto that drive. That doesn't mean I stop marketing. That doesn't mean I stop dead in my business. It just means those are extra things that have to happen to keep my business successfully running the way it needs to. And like you see behind me, I'm still a work in progress to get my room in the right kind of shape for what I want. But, and also the lighting, I've worked around several times to figure out lighting, and right now I'm only using one light, looking practically right into it. And so that makes it so I don't have shadows on my face. And that gives a good video that you can see and enjoy. Because from what I understand, people like to see a real clear picture and they want to see your face. That's something a lot of people have a struggle with, but it's absolutely important to actually show people who you are. So I actually have a link on the bottom of this video today. It's from Finish Line Network. And we're still in launch stage, but we're starting to fill out all of our back office stuff. I'm going to do a tour probably tomorrow on that and share how you can actually get started with it and what it's all about. And I'm not going away from Power Lead System or the Kingdom program that I was showing earlier. I like to do more than one program. I am an affiliate marketer, internet marketer, and I share various different things for the purpose of, usually most programs are not one size fits all. I mean, they can usually address a large audience, but there's something kind of special in each of these that are not in the others. And that's what I want you to look at, is that I have some really cool ideas to share with you in Finish Line Network. One thing that's really cool about it is that we have up to 9-figure earners that are the leaders sharing their kind of secrets inside of how they made their money, and you could learn from them. This is kind of my mentoring program. I always wanted a mentoring program. Now I have one. And you can have an opportunity to look at it for really reasonable, because most mentors that make this kind of money will charge you $1,000 an hour. And this is so affordable in comparison to that. So I wanted you to take a look at that and also think about what real persistence is. And I will be sharing more with you tomorrow now that I've ironed out this video problem. And I hope you have a most amazing afternoon. Bye for now.